This is the Hubba Hubba NX tent by MSR. It's a two-person, three-season tent. It's an ultralight tent, and I've always wanted one of these. I just could never afford it. But thankfully, Outdoor Adventure Store here in Ireland has given me this tent, not to review, but as a gift for my upcoming walk down through the middle of Ireland. So I'm really excited to have this tent for so many different reasons. And today I'm gonna demonstrate how to put it up, how to set up the tent, and then everything about it that, well, as much as I know about it, that I think you guys should know too. So there's four main components to the MSR Hubba Hubba NX tent. You have the inner section of the tent, you have the green rain fly, the fly sheet here to my left, you have the pegs, and you have the poles. The first thing you want to do is lay down the inner section of the tent and then peg it down in each of the four corners with these pegs. The tent is so lightweight, which is a great thing. It's so ultra light that even the faintest breeze can blow the tent over. So if you make sure that you peg down the corners before you start putting the poles together and before you start putting it up, that way you'll know that when you erect the tent with the poles, it's not going to blow away. This is one of the best things about the Hubba Hubba NX tent. The pole system uses these two silver hubs. That's where the tent got its name, Hubba Hubba. And these two silver hubs are so useful in terms of the construction of the tent. I'm going to show you why, I'm going to demonstrate why in a moment. The other thing I just want to mention is, as with many tents, you can see that the poles are tied together with these there's cords inside them, tension cords, and this makes it just so much easier to put the tent up. And it means you're not trying to figure out what pole goes where and how to actually put them together. So as I lift it apart here, you'll see, because of the unique design, it almost puts itself together. As I'm taking the poles apart, some of these poles are even clicking into one another by themselves. So that's one side of the tent already done. And when you finish setting up the poles, all you do is you lay the pole system down on top of the tent. You take each corner and you slot each pole into each corner of the tent. You'll see there's a small eyelet on each corner of the tent, and the poles slot nicely into each of those. Also, just give it a bit of tension there, just push it forward, so that you arch up the middle of the tent, and that way you can fit the poles into each corner quite easily. You just take these plastic black hooks on the inner section of the tent and you clip it on to the pole system. And so that's the basic design, but we're not finished just yet, okay? The one thing I want to mention real quick in terms of the setup of the pole system on this tent is this top bar. You see it goes across the top of the tent like so, but it's going across the top of the tent underneath the main frame. Can you see that? It's going across the top but underneath this main frame. And this is not the way the tent is supposed to be set up according to MSR. And I've seen people make this mistake, so I thought I should say it in the video. This pole, let's clip this back on, this pole is supposed to go across the top of the main frame. And this is important because this pole helps give the tent its overall shape and stability. So if you are out camping on an especially windy night or a stormy night, this pole is going to reduce the possibility of the sides of the tent collapsing in around you. Alright, so it's important to have this pole across the top of the tent, and you do this before you've set it up. And then you can see on each side, you just hook the inner part of the tent onto this pole. So that for the most part is the setup of the Hubba Hubba NX tent. I think you can see that the hub system really does work, and it reduces the complexity of setting up this tent. You can see on the outside here as well, there's a lot of mesh. This is amazing. This is such a great feature. Not only does it provide more ventilation, but if you ever do want to sleep under the stars, you can lie down in here and you can see up through this vent. So it's a great feature of the Hubba Hubba tent. And in terms of the material, think this is 20D and 30D ripstop nylon, which essentially means it's strong, durable material that is reasonably waterproof. And certainly this tent strikes a good balance in terms of the material, the practicality versus the weight of the overall tent. So I'm just going to put the fly sheet on top of the tent and we'll go and take a look inside then. You just put the fly sheet over the top of the inner section of the tent, and for the Hubba Hubba, you take each corner, there's a small eyelet here, and you hook this around the existing peg that's in the corner. On each side of the tent, you just pull out the doorway and you peg this down too. If you're expecting wind or you want a little bit more stability, you can take these guy ropes. These are tied up now because the tent is new. You take these guy ropes and you peg them down too. You just pull them out. You get a bit of tension, have it nice and tight. On each side of the tent, you can peg down these guy lines for a bit more stability and structure. And that's it. That's the setup of the MSR Hubba Hubba NX tent. As you can see, the green rain fly. It's another feature of the tent. If you're someone that likes to go wild camping or you just don't want to be found, this will make sure you blend in with the environment, which is certainly the case in a place like here in Ireland where everything is so green. So for me, that's another feature, especially for people that like wild camping, the green fly. And another thing, as you can see, there's a doorway on each side of the tent. That's amazing. That is an amazing luxury to have on any tent. It means that it's so much easier getting in and out of the tent. But if there's two people sleeping in here, it means you don't have to climb over one another to get in and out of the tent at night. The other thing about the doorways, as you can see, when the fly sheet is up, it creates this porch area, which is known as a vestibule. And this again is really useful. You can put your bag here overnight if you don't want it inside. And it's great for keeping wet gear if it rains or leaving your shoes outside. So the vestibule on each side is a fantastic thing to have. And I'm just going to take you in here now. This is going to be my home for the next month. I'm walking the Ireland way, top to bottom of Ireland, camping every night in the wild, in the fields, wherever I can find somewhere to put the tent. So I'll be sleeping in this tent for the next month. I'm really excited about that. Make sure you hit the subscribe button to keep up with my videos. I'm going to be posting videos every day starting this week of that trip. And thank you to everyone that likes this video. That's how you can help out my channel. I really do appreciate everyone that takes a moment to do that for me. But anyway, back to the tent. You can see here on each side it has a mesh pocket. This is really handy because when you have mesh pockets in a tent, it means you can put small items in there such as your headphones or your head torch. I put my head torch in here at night time, and that way when I wake up in the middle of the night, I don't have to, you know, look for my head torch. I'll know exactly where to reach. It'll be in this pocket above my head and off you go. Another thing you might notice is the amount of space inside this tent. It really is remarkable for a tent this light that you can have this much space inside. A lot of two-person tents, it's a bit of a squeeze for two people, but with the Hubba Hubba NX, you could comfortably fit two people in this, and you have a vestibule on each side to put your bags, so no worries there. A reasonable amount of light gets into the tent, which is a good thing. It's really bright out today, so it probably looks a little bit brighter than normal, but it's a good thing because you don't want to wake up in the morning to complete darkness. You want to wake up to the natural morning light and have your eyes adjust to the natural morning light. So it's nice that a bit of light comes in, but there's not so much that you wouldn't be able to sleep or take a rest during the day if you wanted to do that. And that's really it for the inside of the tent. I'm just amazed by all the features that this one tent has, and this is why this has always been my dream tent. I had a big Agnes copper spur for a few years, which was excellent, but it's bright orange, which is not good for wild camping. You stand out a mile. And I also felt the material is a lot lighter than you will find on the Hubba Hubba. The very last thing I'm going to show you how to do real quick is how to take this tent down and pack it away so that it looks exactly the way you got it. So the first thing you do is unclip the fly sheet and take it off. That's it there in the grass beside me. And before you take the pegs out of each corner, you unclip these plastic hooks here on the pole system. The reason you do this before you take the pegs out so that the tent doesn't blow away. Once you have all the hooks off the pole system, you just take the corner of the poles out of each socket so that it's flat on the ground again. And then you go about dismantling the pole system, which is very easy to do. You just simply pull out of one another and then you fold them up together. put the poles into that bag, put the poles to one side, and then I have the bag with the pegs here. I can now take the pegs out of the ground, put them into this bag too. You fold over the inner section of the tent like this, so that it's in a nice rectangular shape. Then you take the fly sheet, you put the fly sheet along the top, just try and evenly spread it out, like so. It doesn't have to be perfect. Then you take the poles and you take the pegs, you line them up at the very end of the tent, and then you squeeze them together and start rolling it tightly, slowly but tightly. And just make sure it's keeping its shape as you roll. You'll see as I continue doing this, because it's evenly spread out and because it was in a nice shape before I started to roll it up, it's going to be nice and compact when I finish rolling like this. And then that quite easily fits into the bag for the tent exactly the way I got it. This is an amazing tent, as I keep saying. It really is. It only weighs 1.5 kilo, which is about 3 pounds 8 ounces. So it's ultra light and it's really small, so you can fit it inside your backpack, which I've already mentioned too. As you can see, the material, the structure, the design is amazing, and the different features of the tent, they're amazing too. So I really do recommend this tent to long distance hikers in particular, or people that go camping a lot, especially wild camping. The thing is, it's not the most affordable tent in the world, hence the reason I was never able to get one in the past. So if you're not able to afford something like this, or if you just want to test out, go camping for the first time, try wild camping, or you go once in a blue moon, it might not be worth your while to invest in something like this. And you might want to take a look at something like something from the Vango range. The Vango Banshee 200 is another great tent of mine and much more affordable. There's many tents out there. That's it. I really look forward to using this tent over the next month, and I appreciate you coming to watch this video. So thank you for leaving your comments down below. If there's anything that I didn't mention about this tent that you know about, because I'm by no means an expert, please let us know and share what you know about this tent in the comments. Or if you have any other questions about this tent, let me know in the comments about that too. So that's all for now. See you later.